Hey fellow workers, my name's Kim Siever. Welcome back to my channel. In the discourse surrounding socioeconomic stratification, the concept of the middle class often emerges as a central point of reference. It's a term that carries with it connotations of stability, security, and a comfortable standard of living. Upon closer examination, it becomes evident that the middle class is more myth than reality. The term middle class implies that at least three socioeconomic groups exist: lower class, middle class, and upper class. It suggests a level of economic stability and security that distinguishes this group from both the impoverished and the affluent. However, this characterization oversimplifies the complexities of class dynamics and fails to capture the realities of modern capitalism. Middle class is a term frequently invoked in political rhetoric, economic analysis, and everyday conversations. Yet it's a nebulous category that encompasses varying levels of income, wealth, and social status. Attempts to delineate clear boundaries for the middle class inevitably result in arbitrary distinctions that obscure more than they reveal. Because it's not defined, most people think they're part of it. They don't want to be poor, so they're not lower class. But they also don't think they're rich, so they can't be upper class. In reality, however, there is no middle class. There aren't even three classes. Fundamentally, there are just two classes. On one hand, we have the working class, individuals who rely on their labor for income. They are the factory workers, retail employees, service industry workers, office workers, and manual laborers who form the backbone of the economy. Despite their essential contributions to the economy, members of the working class often face economic precarity, low wages, and limited job security. The working class is characterized by its lack of significant ownership or control over the means of production: land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship. The livelihoods of workers are tied to their labor, and they have little autonomy in their workplaces. Yet despite their shared experiences of exploitation and marginalization, and the fact that they make up the vast majority of the population, the working class is often fragmented and divided along lines of race, gender, economic status, and occupation. The very term middle class feeds into this fragmentation by pitting workers against one another along economic status lines. And on the other hand, we have the owning class, those who derive their wealth and power from the ownership of capital. These are the wealthy elite, corporate executives, business owners, landlords, and investors who wield considerable influence over the economy and society at large. Members of the owning class accumulate wealth through ownership and investment, leveraging their capital to maintain control over resources and institutions. The owning class enjoys privileges and opportunities that are inaccessible to the working class. The minority of the population have the means to influence public policy, shape economic outcomes, and perpetuate their own interests at the expense of the majority. The myth of the middle class serves to obscure the fundamental divide between the working class and the owning class. By promoting the illusion of a cohesive middle class, we obscure the structural inequalities and power imbalances that underpin capitalist society. In fact, the notion of a middle class undermines class solidarity among the working class by fostering a sense of false consciousness and division. Rather than recognizing their shared interests and common struggles, working class individuals may internalize the myth of the middle class and aspire to attain middle class status themselves. This can lead to competition and resentment among working class communities as individuals vie for limited opportunities for upward mobility. To challenge the hegemony of the owning class and achieve meaningful social change, the working class must develop a sense of class consciousness and solidarity. We must recognize the systemic nature of capitalism and how capitalism perpetuates inequality and exploitation. By rejecting the illusion of the middle class and embracing a more nuanced understanding of class relations, working class individuals can unite in common cause to demand economic justice, workers' rights, and social welfare. Solidarity among the working class is essential for building collective power and effecting transformative change. Only through solidarity and collective action can the working class challenge the entrenched power structures of capitalism and build a more just and equitable society for all. Solidarity.